In the ACT, this is the state of play. Labor currently has 8 seats. The Greens have 1, Liberals 6. 10 are undecided at this point. But based on the numbers, the early numbers, and the fact that the Liberals are actually have got swings against them in 4 of the 5 constituencies, Labor would consider themselves in the box seat to be re-elected for a 6th straight term, given swings against the Libs in 4 out of the 5 electorates and the fact that they need to pick up 2 seats in order to have a majority. So it looks at this stage like the Labor Party should be feeling pretty confident in this Hare-Clark system with at least 10 seats guaranteed as the count continues. Now, let's bring in Trudy McIntosh at Labor headquarters for an update there. And Trudy, really, there's only 1 seat, Yerribee, where Labor Party's struggling, a big swing against them. But elsewhere, there's swings to the government, Trudy.
Yeah, that's a very interesting divide, Kieran, to see what we are seeing in 4 out of the 5 electorates here is so different than what we're seeing in the furthest north one, that being Yerribee. But I'm joined now by Labor Minister Mick Gentleman. He's also an MLA for Brindabella, which is the seat that represents Tuggeranong, further south to Thala. Mick, how have you made the results so far today?
So I've looked at some of the results, particularly in my suburb, Brindabella. We seem to be doing quite well at the moment, and I think that goes down to the hard work and effort that we've put into the electorate over the last 4 years. I want to thank, of course, the people of Brindabella for their support 4 years ago and again this year. We have been ensuring, of course, the safety of those people in Brindabella during a very difficult time for Canberrans, and the fire was closest to that electorate, of course, during the bushfire season. So we've had bushfire season, we've had, of course, the terrible storms, and now the COVID pandemic, and I think people are just want to see a steady hand on the tiller for the future for Canberra.
In Brindabella, Liberals currently have 3 MLAs, Labor with 2. Do you think there is a real chance tonight that we could see that 3rd Labor MLA gained in Brindabella?
Well, I won't make any pronouncements yet. But of course the theme arising seems to be more of a move towards Labor and the Greens in Brindabella and away from the Liberal Party.
In terms of 2016, we know that the light rail had been such a big issue. It seemed like at the time Labor was being punished for the fact that it hasn't crossed south across the lake. Certainly many areas that you represent are no closer to seeing that tram. Are you still hearing that on the ground, or is that an issue now that's gone away?
No, we're not hearing that on the ground. And of course with the introduction of light rail, it freed up 1,000 bus kilometres to be used right across the ACT, so that means that we can have more buses down the south as well. And there's been some changes to the network. They'll be bedded down, and I think people will be more happy with their transport solutions.
The Chief Minister's certainly making a lot of the late in this campaign of how Alistair Coe has been doing a lot of stunts in the lead-up to Election Day. What have you made of that? Do you think that's been something the voters have actually liked?
I'm not sure. I haven't had much comment back from the voters in Brindabella about those sorts of actions. I would say that as a boxer, though, you probably need to lead, of course, with your left and then follow through with the right. But we'll see how that plays out, I think.
All right, thanks so much for your time, Mick. I really appreciate it. Good
Pleasure.
Luck tonight.
Thank you.
Kieran, it's certainly going to be a much more buoyant mood here. COVID's changed how a lot of these things are not actually allowed to stand the supporters here. They must be seated as a result of these COVID restrictions.
Yeah, well, tight restrictions given there hasn't been a case in the ACT for well over 3 months. Thank you, Trudy. Let's go to Jonathan Lee at Canberra Liberal headquarters. Jonathan, you've also got a Brindabella Member of Parliament with you.
I have. I've actually got Mark Parton beside me. I'll bring you in a second. But at the moment, Kieran, there is a sense from some of the Liberals that they've seen this movie before. They want to remain optimistic. You look at Yerribee, there's talk of a swing there to the Liberal Party of 8%, a swing away from the Labor Party of 10%. But there's swings away from the Liberals in 3 other electorates, Kurrajong, Murrumbidgee and Brindabella. Talk there of perhaps 1 to 2%, perhaps across the 5 electorates. You're looking at a swing perhaps 1.2% away from you at the moment.
Yeah, and look, it's early in the night and there's still a lot of votes to be counted. And I know that we've ended up getting a lot through the electronic voting, but there's a lot of water to pass under the bridge. And I just want to say that it does appear as though I've been returned to the Assembly. And the first thing you've got to do is say thanks to all the people that have helped you, because there's, you know, I'm not going to name them here, but all the people, including my wife and my campaign manager, Rob Lovett, it's been awesome. This is hard yards, election campaigns, mate. It's tough. And, you know, as much the people that are here in this room are celebrating their hard work, and everyone has worked very, very hard.
It's even harder in a pandemic. There's been no oxygen for the opposition at the moment. We heard before, you look at the summer of disaster. We had bushfires, then we had the hailstorm, $1.6 billion worth of damage there, apparently 1 in 10 cars damaged. Then you've gone into a pandemic. Nobody wants to hear from an opposition.
No, they don't. And so it is like the election campaign that you're having when you're not having an election campaign. You know, we for a long period of time, we couldn't do any shopping centres, we couldn't do door knocking. We were very, very limited at what we could do. But at the same time, the government's getting all of this airspace every single day because they have to run the pandemic, or they have to run the response to the pandemic, as you would expect them to do. But yes, it's been difficult for the opposition to get some oxygen.
There's a very unique voting system, as we all know, in the ACT. Is there any way that you can stomach a loss or a swing against you in some seats and still find a path to victory?
Look, all I would say is, in my time in the media, I sat in a number of these nights where we, you know, pulled apart the ACT election results, and a lot of people made some early calls and ended up with egg on their face. So things can change dramatically.
You're not saying the media gets it wrong.
On occasions, things can change dramatically during the night. There is a lot of water still to pass under the bridge, and I think we're still in the hunt.
Just before I throw back to Kieran, tell me about your party's election platform. In many ways, it wasn't based on debt and deficit, which is what we traditionally expect from a Liberal Party or a coalition. It was talking about hip pocket issues. Some people might say it was actually more of a grassroots Labor sort of movement, giving money back to people.
Yes, it was. I mean, we did focus on cost of living, and certainly so many of the, you know, hundreds, if not thousands of people that I spoke to, that message very much resonated with them. So, you know, if indeed the tide turns and we do pull this off, that's why we did it.
If, it's a big word.
It is if.
Kieran, that's what we're dealing with at the moment. If ifs and buts were cakes and nuts, we'd all have a Merry Christmas, I think they'd say.
I like it, Jonathan. Thanks very much. And wise words from Mr. Parton there, to be cautious. We're expecting a big dump of some numbers, some data soon from the ACT Electoral Commission, which could give us a much more definitive indication of where tonight's heading. But let's have an update now. I'll show you each of the seats. Brindabella, first up. Now, just a reminder, as Jonathan alluded to there, it's a hair clerk system. So you look at that quota column. ACT Labor with 2.5 at this stage. The Greens or Labor looks like fighting it out for that fifth seat in Brindabella with 2 for the Liberals. Let's look at Ginninderra. And incidentally, if Labor wins another one, that would be an additional seat in Brindabella. In Ginninderra, 2.5 seats again for Labor and the Greens with 0.7. Canberra Liberals, 1.6, so quite a swing away from the Liberals there, and that's because of that pink column there, Belco First, led by the former Liberal, Bill Stefaniak, and that's got, heading towards one quota as well. So the Liberals potentially, depending on how these numbers go, could hold on to 2 seats there, which they have at the moment, or could lose it to Belco First. Labor and the Greens, again, fighting it out for 1 seat in Ginninderra. Currajong, that's Andrew Barr's seat. He will be safely returned, 2.3. Shane Rattenbury's the Green member there, and well over 1 quota there. And the Liberals, close to their current 2. So looks like status quo situation for the CBD and surrounding areas in Currajong. At this stage anyway. Now, let's look at Murrumbidgee. Labor were quite bullish there earlier, and that's, they've got 2 seats already. Looks like that's going to be the status quo. In fact, the Greens heading for another seat. They have 1 seat in Murrumbidgee already. So, again, that status quo situation looks like for both Currajong and Murrumbidgee a likely scenario at this point. Now, Yerribee's where Labor's copped it, a big swing away from Labor in the northern suburbs, 8.8%, most of that going to the Liberals. So currently you've got 3 Labor seats and 2 Liberal seats in Yerribee. That's going to flip by the looks of this situation this evening, that Labor will go to 2 and the Liberals potentially picking up a seat there in Yerribee, depending how that the Greens vote holds up over the next little while. But we're expecting a big dump of data, as I say, from the Electoral Commission shortly.